Hello all, welcome to this video on microprocessors and microcontrollers. Today we'll be solving a problem on 8051 assembly language program to count the number of ones and zeros in a given 8-bit number. For this we'll consider three registers, R1 as a counter for ones, R2 as counter for zeros and R3 as counter for total number of bits. We'll also use the logical instruction RRC which will rotate right the accumulator with carry. The LSB of accumulator enters into the carry flag and original carry enters into the MSB of the accumulator. All other bits are shifted by one position to the right. Here carry is a part of the rotation loop. We'll also use the jump instructions JNC which jumps to the specified relative address if the carry flag is not set and DJN is set, which will decrement the specified operand and jump to the specified relative address only if the content of the specified operand is not zero. Now let us start writing the program. First of all, we'll assume that the 8-bit number here is 5. This is its 8-bit value, which will be copied to the accumulator. So the first statement is move A, #05H. Here hash is used as a prefix to show that this is an 8-bit immediate data. We'll also initialize the registers R1 and R2 with 0, which is written as move R1, #00H, move R2, #00H. We'll also initialize the value of R3 with the value 8, since 8 is the total number of bits. So it is written as move R3, #08H. In the previous slide, we have seen that carry flag is used throughout in the program. So we'll clear it using the statement CLRC. In the following statements, what it does is we'll perform a right rotation of the accumulator by 1-bit position, take that value into the carry flag and check whether it's a 1 or 0. If it's 1, R1 is incremented. If it's 0, R2 is incremented. After each checking, we'll perform a decrement on R3 and check whether it's a 0. If it's not 0, the set of statements are again repeated. And when it's 0, it means that the count has been completed. Now let us move on to the first rotation. Before that, we'll see the initial value of the accumulator and the carry flag. With positions are marked from 0 to 7 and carry flag with value is 0. Now, after the first rotation, the value in the least significant bit here will be copied to the carry flag and the carry flag value will be copied to the MSB of the accumulator, which means the carry bit is 1. Since the carry bit is 1, we'll increment the value of R1. So R1 becomes 1 and we'll jump to the location labeled by the label exit, where R3 will be decremented by 1. So R3 is 7. Since 7 is not 0, we'll go for the second rotation. For the second rotation, this bit will be copied to the carry flag and the value of carry will be copied to the MSB of the accumulator. Now, we'll have the carry bit value as 0. So, we'll decrement R2. So, the current value of R2 is 1 and we decrement the value of R3. Now, R3 becomes 6. Since 6 is not 0, we'll go for the third rotation. For the third rotation, the value here is copied to the carry flag and this value is copied to the MSB. Now the carry flag value is 1. Since it's 1, we'll increment the value of R1. Now R1 becomes 2 and we'll decrement the value of R3, which is 5 now. And check whether it's 0. Since 5 is not 0, we'll go for the next rotation. For the next rotation, we'll copy the value here, which is 0, to the carry flag and 1 is copied to the MSB. Now we have the carry flag value as 0. Since it's 0, we'll increment R2 and then we decrement the value of R3. Now R3 becomes 4. Since 4 is not 0, we'll go for the next rotation. There, we'll copy the value here to the carry flag and 0 is copied to the MSB. Now, since carry flag is again 0, it means R2 is incremented. Now, R3 is decremented, which means R3 becomes 3. Since 3 is not 0, we'll go for the next rotation where 0 is copied here and the carry flag bit is copied to the MSB. Again, the carry bit is 0, so we'll increment the value of R2. And now R3 will be decremented by 1, so R3 becomes 2. Since it's not 0, we'll go for the next rotation. So for the next rotation, this 0 is copied to the carry flag and this 0 will be copied to the MSB. We have a 0 again, so R2 will be incremented and we'll decrement R3 by 1, which is 1. Since 1 is not 0, we'll go for the next rotation. The next rotation, this 0 will be copied to the carry flag and this 0 will be copied to the MSB. Since it's a 0 again, we'll increment the value of R2 and decrement the value of R3. Now, R3 is 0, which means the comparison is over. So, the final value of R1 will be 2 and R2 will be 6, which gives us a total of 8 bits. We'll write each of these values into the accumulator and end the program with the End assembly directive. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for listening.